Hi, I'm Mark Pocock from the Electrical Safety Office. As you're aware, the wiring rules are being updated, so I wanted to talk you through some of the key changes to safety switch requirements and mechanical protection of cabling. They will appear in the next edition, due for release later this year. We have been a strong advocate for the use of safety switches. The new edition supports this approach with an increase in safety switch requirements, now a must on all final subcircuits in domestic and residential installations. The existing requirements for maximum 3 circuits per RCD, minimum 2 RCDs, still remain for domestic and residential electrical installations. For non-domestic and non-residential electrical installations, 30 milliamp RCDs shall be installed on all lighting and socket outlet final subcircuits less than or equal to 32 amps. 30 milliamp RCDs should be installed on all final subcircuits less than or equal to 32 amps, supplying fixed wired electrical equipment. 30 milliamp RCDs shall be installed on all final subcircuits supplying fixed wired electrical equipment that may represent an increased risk of electric shock. This could be environmental conditions such as wet areas and the type of electrical installation or processes being conducted there. For home care medical installations, the RCD requirements for medical equipment in home care medical installations shall comply with AS 3003. The wiring rules refers to AS 3003, so if you work on home care electrical installations, then you will need to refer to this standard. It is noted that AS 3003 has been completely revised with a new edition published in 2017. With an increase in the number of allied trades working in the vicinity of electrical cables, it is most important that mechanical protection of cabling is provided. More detailed requirements for mechanical protection for cables installed within a ceiling space, wiring systems near building surfaces, and wiring systems likely to be disturbed are included in the new edition. For further information, visit our website, electricalsafety.qld.gov.au.